About 4,000 people live in and around Ladakh in Arunachal Pradesh. It took us 17 hours drive and 10 hours to walk to reach this place from the nearest town where surgical care is possible. During the diagnostic camps, we saw over 400 patients and about 3% of them had urinary tract stones. Do you think it would be possible to treat these patients in such remote areas where there's no electricity? Yes is the answer. Now, thanks to this laptop cystoscope, all you need to do is to connect the scope to the laptop computer and start doing these diagnostic scopies or minor procedures. Gone are the days when you needed the expensive telescope, camera, light source, etc. for such procedures. The cost of the laptop cystoscope would be less than 1/20th of the traditional setup. If you're in a place with good internet connectivity, it is possible for experts to see your screen from a remote location and give you advice on what to do. The International Federation of Rural Surgeons and the Association of Rural Surgeons of India are collaborating to start a real-time online training program with university certification and accreditation. Few rural surgeons in Northeast India are already doing these minor procedures using the laptop cystoscope. Some urology and even some non-urology surgeries are possible with the laptop cystoscope. So what are the requirements for doing a small procedure like a cystoscopy or a minor procedures like a DJ stenting? If it were not for this low-cost or ultra-low-cost cystoscope that we have, you would need a cystoscope, which consists of three things. One is a telescope, then the sheath, and a bridge. The cystoscope, the telescope, is the most expensive part of this. Even the least expensive Chinese scopes cost about 80,000 rupees. An average of good ones about 120,000 rupees. And the good ones from standard companies well over 300,000 rupees. But that's not it. Then you need the camera to connect to the monitor, then or a television set. Then you need the light source to power the telescope. And the entire set can range anywhere between 600,000 to double that amount. Okay, then you might be wondering, if there are so much advantages, are there any disadvantages to this scope? This scope, what we are seeing here is the first generation one. And the first slide will show the second and the third generation scopes that we have made. So what is the disadvantage of these scopes? Here what we have done is, we replaced the telescope with an endoscopic camera. So this dramatically reduces the cost because, as I said earlier, the telescope is the most expensive part of this entire system. And it has many rod lengths and it's quite a complicated thing to produce. But the advantage of the telescope is that it's a cold light source. It transmits lights and pictures. It transmits the lights from the light source into the bladder and the pictures from the bladder into the eyepiece. And there's no heat transfer here. So, but with the endoscopic camera, the light is right at the tip of the camera. So that produces heat. It is not a big problem in urology because as we mentioned earlier, we have a fluid which is irrigating and washing away. So this will remove the heat. So it's not a major problem if you're doing a cystoscopy or a DJ stenting, any of those procedures, as long as you have this irrigating fluid which is there. But if you're using it for diagnostic laparoscopy or any other procedure, appendectomy and so on, you should not do it for a long time because you should understand that there is sufficient heat and this heat can destroy tissues. most of the scopes that we use are 30 degree scope. In other words, it look down, it's bent about 30 degrees, so the vision is downwards. Here it is 0 degrees, so you have to look straight. But looking straight is good for urethra, where we have there any strictures and other problems, it's easier to look straight. But in the bladder, what happens is that you, most of the bladder in the is under, I mean, the trigone and the posterior aspect of the bladder is sort of straight. So it might be, I mean, it's easier to do with the 30 degrees to view down. But here you'll have to move in such a way that you need to look at the 0 degrees telescope. We are trying to see if they have any 30 degrees camera, or whether we can rotate the camera a little bit and fix it. But right now that is not possible. We'll have only a 0 degree camera and 0 degree vision. These are all autofocus cameras. So it takes a little while for the mechanism to focus and give sharper images. So you need to be fairly gentle to do these procedures. So you need to slowly do the scopy and the stenting and other thing. But it's not a major problem, because anyway, it's good to be gentle when you're doing all these procedures.
So this is what the scope looks like now. I hope it's clear. And this is the tip. If you can see, this is where the camera is. And we have a single locking mechanism here. This is for your instruments or disposables to go through. And it now has a 5 meter cable, which gives you enough length in case for sterilization. You can put maybe 1 meter or even more for sterilization. It does not matter. And at the other end, we have USB 2 attachment. The standard USB attachment, and you can fold it back and reveal a micro USB connection. This micro USB will attach your cystoscope to even any Android phone or any smartphone. And for C-type phones, we have another C-type adapter here. I hope it's clear. So you just need to insert this into this, and then it's ready to be used.
If you have a very bright light and very close to the tissue, then quite a lot of it is reflected. You won't see very clear pictures. So you need to reduce the light when you go closer.
So what you can see now is the feed. This is a scope, the feed from the scope. I'm just going to put it inside my hand. And the lights are off now. So I'm just going to increase the light to maybe about 50%. So the lower the light, the more you'll have a grainy footage, a grainy video. So you need to find the right balance for your, now I'm increasing it. This is at about 100%. And I'll just reduce it to maybe about 80. So this
is. How far away are you from the tip of the camera and the.
So, just a second.
How many centimeters, maybe?
Can you see my cursor? So this is my thumb.
Yeah.
This is my thumb.
So your thumb is how far away from the camera now?
So my thumb is now about 5 centimeters away.
Okay.
So I'm just going closer.
So about 5 centimeters, you can have the maximum brightness, or 80-90% of the brightness.
Yeah. It would depend on your. So now I'm at about 3 centimeters from the thumb. This is my thumb.
And if you notice, about 2 to 3 centimeters is the ideal distance for very clear vision. So if you're seeing any lesion like a TCC bladder, or you want to have a closer look, then it's better to keep that about 2 to 3 centimeters away from the tip of the camera.
So I'm now at about less than 2 centimeters from my thumb.
Yeah.
So you can see that the image sharpness has gone down a little bit. The contours are smoother now. There's less sharpness. I want to go further away. So now I'm at about 2.5 centimeters away. This is where you start getting very good sharp images.
Now, go very close and start reducing the light to show them the effect.
So now I'm at about 1 centimeter.
Just go closer without reducing the light. Go closer. See, now we can see, at least in the left half of the picture, a lot of reflected light. See, if you have a bright light, then there's a lot of reflection. You won't be able to see the picture clearly. Now reduce the light. The clarity will improve as you reduce the light. So this is one thing you need to learn. With experience, you'll learn when to reduce the light, when to increase the light. The idea is to have the optimum or best possible vision.
So I'm at about now 15-20%. And I'm less than, I'm about 5 mm away from the thumb. So I'm now moving away. This is about 1 centimeter.
Yeah.
This is about 2 centimeter. And here now we are about maybe 3 centimeter. But we are still at 15%, about 15% brightness. I'll increase it to about maybe 50%. So you can see how the image is changing. Another thing is color representation may take some time. If you increase or decrease, it may change. That's one thing you have to keep in mind.
Does it have any white balance? Or?
No, sir. We don't have a white balance as yet. So now I'm at about 5 centimeters again. So the thing is, we need gentle movements. If I make it a bit fast, you can see how the picture is getting blurred, number one, and how, number two, how the image representation also changes. You need to be gentle with your movements.
So normally you will not need more than 10 centimeters because even if you distend the bladder almost to the full, if it is up to the umbilicus, still it won't be more than 10 centimeters to download and install anything.
It's a very small file. It's hardly about less than 10 MB.
No.
So downloading it is not a problem. If anybody wants to have the cystoscope, then we can include.
And what about recording? Does it have facilities for recording?
Yeah. If you can see on my screen, you can take a photo, you can take still photos, you can record video, and you have the settings over here. So you can change the settings. It's called Super Eyes. This is the name of the device. And then for the video format, there's a range of formats here. I prefer to use the default and not get stuck with other things. The recording method is AVI, which is one of the common recording interfaces. And the other things, maybe you don't need to, you can even specify the part where you would like to save your videos. So what I will do is I go to my Zoom. This is my Zoom. I will say share, and I just need to share either my screen or smart camera. This is very easy. Anybody who's using Zoom, I think you should be knowing how to share your screen. So you just share your screen.
And now we can see.
Yeah, so I'm just sharing my screen now, so you just need to be able to do that. You can either choose to share just your screen, or you can choose to share only the software that
That software, can you make it full screen? But now we see only in...
you can just double click. Yeah. Just need to double click.
Okay.
So now we are at full screen.
It's a very simple device to use. You either have a... If you have a laptop computer, you have a USB port which you need to connect to the laptop, or if you have a regular older generation Android port, you remove part of that USB connector, and there's a smaller connector which is inside, which you need to use for the regular cell phone, or C-type connector if you have a modern cell phone. So then you see the pictures. So if you want to share your pictures, all you need to do is just, you can either share screen from your cell phone or laptop, or the software screen of the software which you install for viewing in the pictures. And also you can take snapshots of these pictures. Say if you have any disease, if there is a lesion in the TCC in the bladder, you can just take a picture of that. Or if you want to record the entire procedure, that is also possible in the same software that is given along with the endoscopic camera. And the ideal distance to use is about 2 to 7 centimeters from the lesion. And if you're doing for urology, you don't have to worry about the heat which is generated at the tip. But if you're using it for any other lesions, or like for diagnostic laparoscopy or in the abdomen, you need to be aware of the heat and not touch anything, any of the bowel or any of those things, because the heat can cause perforation. Actually, the Association of Rural Surgeons of India and the International Federation of Rural Surgeons. So one is an Indian association and the other one is an international association. Both are joined together and we have formed what is called a Rural Surgery Research and Training Center in one of the hospitals in Jharkhand. And through this, we have devised this course for gastric surgeries and rural urology and spinal anesthesia and so on. And we have these courses accredited to the Martin Luther University in Shillong. So this center is accredited to the university. So once you finish this course, you'll get a certification from the university. The university will arrange for an examination and a credentialing program. And once you're found to be capable of doing all these procedures on your own, then they will give them, you will get a certification. So this process is already started. And the advantage of this rural urology certificate course is that the whole thing can be done online and real time.